Welcome to Attleboro Update. As we approach the midterm elections on November 4th, the local races for office have been heating up. Last Thursday, the United Regional Chamber of Commerce and the Sun Chronicle hosted a state representative and a state senate debate at the Attleboro City Hall. There, Burt Buckley faced off against incumbent Paul Harrow for the state representative seat, and Dylan Hare faced off against incumbent Richard Ross for the state senate. To get a closer look at the evening's events, we spoke with the Sun Chronicle's managing editor, Craig Borges.
Welcome, everyone, to tonight's debate between the two candidates for state representative, representing, of course, the city of Attleboro. Tonight's debate is sponsored by the Sun Chronicle and the United Regional Chamber of Commerce. I want to welcome not only the people who are watching on television, but the people who have assembled here at Attleboro City Hall.
Yeah, the Sun Chronicle sponsored the debate between both our Senate candidates and representative candidates. We feel it's important to get the visions of both candidates, of all four candidates, out to the public, the best way for the public to be informed when they head to the voting booth.
Thank you, gentlemen. The first question this evening will be asked by Sun Chronicle columnist Bill Gouveia, and you will be asking the question of Mr. Ross.
Thank you. Senator.
Basically, we kind of run all our debates in a similar fashion. We have usually two to three panelists today. We had three. Jack Lank from the Chamber of Commerce, Jim Han, he's a reporter, political reporter for the Sun Chronicle, and Bill Gouveia, he's a columnist for the Sun Chronicle. And usually two to three panelists, and they ask each candidate questions, and then the opposing candidate gets a rebuttal, and then both candidates ask one another questions. And that's pretty much how most debates that we sponsor go, because it gives a broad cross-section of interest and different questions rather than having just one panelist or one moderator ask. I think it went really well. Both of them actually did a good turnout despite horrific weather out there that a lot of people turned out. And with you guys doing it on cable, it's great that people were able to see it at home if they didn't want to brave the storm. Both candidates in a rep race handled themselves well, and then the Senate was even better. I hope it informed people, voting public out there in the district.